Miles Calvert. Hey, a new artist and resident here at McColl. So the way this works is they come here and they stay here for a while. And he just got here, so he's going to be here until December. So this is his place. We'll have to ask him some questions. I'm glad he changed Zoom. Because I don't have the right cables, so I gotta carry it. It'll work out. God, that's an amazing print, though. What the hell are these? Do you see these?
Yeah.
You see these right here?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Look at that. Oh, I love that. I want that. I wonder if it's finished. I think it's like he's working together to combine them. Look, speedball acrylics. I used to love this stuff. I was huge in printmaking. Back when I used to do art, a long time ago. And this is, we're at the McColl Center, so we're on the second floor. On the second floor of the McColl. Those. Can you see this? Can you see the etching? Those are so cool. Kind of paper you can make. Oh, we've never had this view before. So the church is converted, right? This is an old converted church. The McColl Center is converted, right? That's the part they didn't actually restore. We'll go down there at some point.
He has his plotter running. I'm not going to kick videos. Hopefully. Facilities
have access to it. Michelle. Michelle. Come on. Okay. And you know what? I can do those things. You can just plug it through. I'm like, sure. Yeah.
Call me anytime, please.
Thank you.
Wow. This is so cool. I got to hear all about your process and everything.
Where do we even start with that question?
I mean, I saw your speedball. I mean, there's a kid. The kid in me likes to do calligraphy.
Oh, cool! Yeah.
You know, once upon a time, every time I see the speedball brand, I think of like calligraphy pens and all of that jazz. You know,
I was introduced to screen printing using speedball products for grad.
Yeah.
And then just kind of ran with it.
Yeah.
And then I've been using their products for an art and paper that they're making. All my students were winning the competition that they had with that paper.
Oh boy, did they hold a competition and everything?
They did for about 3 years and stopped recently. But then they reached out and they're like, hey, do you want to use our products and be like a demo artist for us? So they sent me to places
to play.
That's
oh really?
Not to sell anything. I don't have to sell a thing and I never would.
No.
Yeah.
To show options.
Yeah.
So I love that they're like, hey, go do this for us and we'll, you know, give you all these products.
Yeah.
But I love their color ranges.
Yeah, it's funny, the smell just takes me back, you know.
I had some of the block ink out, I would say, 2 hours ago. So that's probably one of the things that I discovered.
And you've been doing etching too? And
yeah, so the little etchings outside,
okay.
Those are all made from copper plates and ferric chloride acid. And I use a combination of my little plotter and to tone them and tint them.
So it's
technology into my work.
It's not like a laser or something. It's like actual
little
etching.
So replacing that with literally an etching blade.
He's got a tattoo and etch.
Oh my goodness.
That's a fun one to explain, I'm sure.
Yeah. Well, to young people, it's a Harry Potter wand.
And
to my parents, it's a barbecue skewer. So I get every generation.
Oh, that's awesome. What's this going to become? This is like speaking to the skater in me. I'm like, one. Oh, yeah. I don't know. What's up with that?
I don't even know yet.
Yeah, that's the creative process.
These are the fluffy papers and the optical art ones and laser cut out. I'll probably end up using them like a Chine Collet process and fuse them into an etching, a larger etching.
Oh.
But I don't know yet, which is the happy place.
Yeah, I've learned this with Doris. It's like, where is this going?
I don't know.
It's like, well, what about this one over here? I don't know about that one either. We'll see. This is amazing. Thank you, Miles, for showing us around.
Hey, no problem. No problem.
All right, should we go through this place in a proper way? Special kind of person to be a dancer, you know? I mean, just think about it. Church. I don't think I can go out that door. Oh, it smells so good right there. Are you coming home to me? I'm parking in LA. So I'm gonna send an Uber to your place. It's my secret safe. Safe with just you and me. We can leave a trace. Look in my eyes. Can you find a light? Do you feel alive? Look in my eyes. Do you find a light? Yeah, this is okay. So let me start. Oh my God! I wish you could smell this. I wish you could smell this right now. I have to stay behind the line here. We don't want to get in trouble. I wish you could smell this. It's so crazy good. You may have used to work close to this place. Where? At the valet place? You should come down here and hang out with us. I'm just here with the art. So we're kind of early. It started right at 6 o'clock. So we started at 6. Yeah, we've been down here before. This is where my wife's residency is. And they're celebrating tonight the arrival. It's kind of loud, but they're celebrating the arrival of three or four new residents. And we just met one of them, Miles. We just met Miles. Miles is one of the residents. So they're just getting going. They're gonna go until 9 o'clock. But we could I don't know, we could probably come back when there's a bigger crowd. I kinda wanna walk around while it's still light outside, you know? That dog stole somebody's food. Yeah, they're still setting up. Should we go walk up and down? Let's go walk up and down Tryon. Let's go for a nice city walk really quick. We'll come back. We'll come back and get a roadie. Yeah, we'll come back and get a roadie later. I just wanted, while we have sunlight, I figured we could walk up and down Charlotte. Oh, I'm gonna eat. Don't get me wrong, I'm gonna definitely eat. Yeah, it was raining last time. I've been here a couple times actually, two or three times. So here we are. I gotta straighten my camera. How's that? Seeing an IRL stream in your actual city? This is a great city, isn't it not? Phelim? Kind of my city too. I mean, I live in Mooresville, but you know what I mean. Hey, is it too janky? I set it to narrow instead of wide for the art. Should I set it back to wide? You think I should set it back to wide? You guys like this? Kind of narrow. A bit more free form. We're just gonna walk down Tryon and back. It's so nice out right now. Really, really nice out. That's what they have. That's what they feed the homeless. They have quite a collection of, and that's the Vapa Center. We went there the other day. We're gonna probably go back there again too. Been back there in a while. I should probably get a scooter. Jeremy, to rent a scooter. I think I have enough money to rent a scooter this time. I should do that, huh? I should rent a scooter. Charlotte at 6 o'clock. Friday night. Nightlife's just getting going. Ambulance already. Wide when I'm out. You wanna try that? Alright. Let me see if I can get good enough to switch it on the fly. Yeah, let me try. Is it wide now? Did it go wider? It should have just went wider. Hey. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've been to Wilmington. I love Wilmington. There's a chance we're going to live there. Yeah. So Greensboro, actually. Greensboro is one of my wife's backup places to go for MFA, her Master's of Fine Arts. It's actually one of her backup places. They got the scooters. And yeah, we're at kind of a nice chill time in between nightlife, and like everyone's home eating dinner before they go out, you know. Yeah, Wilmington's great though, man. Wilmington. I've been to Lincolnton, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my stepson used to God, should we get a scooter? I could probably do a scooter with this rig. I just don't know how to do them. Should we do one? No riding on sidewalks. Well, now's the time to do it. I don't know. Should we try it? You're from Lincolnton? Yeah, Lincolnton's awesome. I love Lincolnton. Lincolnton's where they have skiing and stuff. It's also where I think Amazon has a... Doesn't Amazon have a warehouse there? If I remember right. I mean, not a warehouse. Amazon's got like a center there or something. See, this is everybody, they get together. That's when they eat. They feed the homeless and stuff. This is dinner time. That makes me hungry. Maybe I should go stand in line. I'm sure that wouldn't be a good thing. Arts, justice, inclusion, First Methodist Church. I kind of want to go get like a... I kind of want to get... like a... I wonder if the church is open. It's like... sure, first... I wonder if we could just go in there. Looks like they might actually be open tonight. Not very many people. Newton Conover? Oh, you might be right. Hey, this is usually blocked off. Yeah, it is. It's permanently blocked off. You can't go in those doors. You have to go in this side. Wait. Nope. Yeah, it's worth a shot. Town is beautiful. Yep. Yeah, I got 8 hours of batteries. But I'm probably not going to be here for that long. Because I want to... They close it at 9, so I'll probably drive home 8:30. And then... I'm trying to find a smoothie. Something good to eat, you know. Okay, man, there's not a lot of people out tonight. It's because we're still like all the work people just left and all the banks stuff are downtown a little bit farther. Then after that we'll end up. Yeah, like all the little places to eat are closed because everyone, all the working people are home. Gotta find another way in. Acquire smoothie. We're in Skyrim. Acquire smoothie. You're currently running low on health. You need to find AI. Oh, let's go show everybody this. So I have to show you this. This is a big... I always tell the story when I go here, but I have to show you this. There's a big piece of art up here. It's gonna be hard to see. You see that up there? This is the Bank of America building. This is like Bank of America's headquarters. Yeah, there's lots of Which one, the Bank of America? Yeah, a lot of people work here, man. And then I wanna live back there. You see those apartments back there? Let me show you. We'll go look. How are you? I'm just giving a tour.
Okay.
Wow, it's so pretty back here.
Is that like a video?
Yeah, I'm live streaming to Twitch.
Oh.
Say hi, I got people in Germany and everything. You don't have to be on if you don't want. I usually cover it up. I don't like.
Okay.
But there you go. Okay. I'm playing catch with her dog. This is a really nice building. This whole area is really nice, actually. I would really love to live down here. That dog needs to learn how to catch a frisbee like Sam. Alright. Should we go around so we don't freak him out again? Let's do that. Good old BOA corporate security tip. Yeah, they're nice. They're super nice. This is like beautiful, huh? Man, this is like, it really is kind of like a quest. You found, unlock the scooter. Ah, walking's fine. Walking is fine. Do, do, do. There's another renovated church. St. Peter's Episcopal Church. Lots of churches. Lots of churches, indeed. Look at that architecture, though. Isn't that great? God, it's so gorgeous. It really does feel like Skyrim. I mean, look at that architecture. It's just like... There I am again. Hi. I'm just that weird guy with the thing coming off his arm. I'm that weird guy. Prague, yes. Can we go in here? I seriously doubt it, but... Caution, fresh grave out. Okay, no. That would be a no. That would be a no. Go away. I promise I'm not scary. I'm just walking here. Just walking here. I'm just walking here. I think it is still a church. I don't know. It looked like it to me. It still says St. Peter's Episcopal Church right there, you know? I think it might actually still be a church. You know? Get down here. I don't like filming people that don't want to be filmed.
No trespassing.
Sanctuary. I want sanctuary. 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 Capricorn. Capricorn 8. Stop, runner! Stop, runner! There are not many NPCs today. Nope, not that many. Little try and I always go down this particular path every time. I don't know why. Hey, if I get an F, let me know, because I'm not looking at my thing all the time. So please let me know if I F. Yeah, it's still open. Check it. Monday through Friday, 8:30 evening prayer. We just barely missed evening prayer. Yeah, we barely missed. I'll have to come earlier next time. We can go pray. We can go pray with the Episcopalians. They're cool. Yeah, Episcopalians are cool. Church was established 1834. Came in Paris, Episcopal Diocese, North Carolina, 1844. Located on the west side of Tryon. Center of activity in Charlotte. In 1865, Jefferson Davis and his retreating Confederate cabinet worshipped at St. Peter's following the assassination of Lincoln. That day, the church's rector preached a sermon on the great tragedy of the death of the president. St. Peter's also had a long history of ministering to Charlotte in 1878. The church was founded by St. Peter's Hospital. Well, founded it. The church surrendered the hospital charter in 1938 and provided financial support and 30 acres of property. The church formed Good Samaritan Hospital, one of the nation's first hospitals for African Americans, which operated until 1961 on the site of the Panther Stadium. In 1979, the church founded the St. Lots of that. That's fire department, though. St. Peter's is known as, quote, the Mother Episcopal Church in Charlotte, and its clergy and members have played key roles in founding numerous Mecklenburg County Episcopal missions and churches. I don't know. Among all the Christians, they all have a thing, right? Like, different thing. I like the Episcopalians, Presbyterians, and the Jesuits. I feel like they live their religion more than the rest. I know that's mean to say. I just offended a whole bunch of people, but I do. I feel like they live their religion more than most. Quakers too. Skateboarder. I miss skateboarding. This is a discovery zone. Where did my thing go? My jink chat keeps crashing. I'm not a fan of Southern Baptists. No. Fuck no. Sorry. Sorry. I told you somebody's gonna get mad at me. Never looked at the plaque even though you walked by it. I know. There's like so many things. They're cool here. Can you see the kaleidoscope? Did that work? Hey, it worked. That's cool. Yeah, we're right by the heart measuring thing. Yeah. We're right by the heart measuring. This is the science center. It's where, yeah, you go right here. You can say stuff. Check, check, check. Check, 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 check. You can like whisper. You have to have somebody on the other side. You have to have somebody go over there and do it. It just doesn't work with just one person. You have to have two people. You have to have somebody over there. This is a happy time of night. All right, should we measure ourselves? It's gonna make a joke about me. It always does. Is it on? Oh, it's turned off.
Still, I'm gonna measure you.
Okay.
You are 8 feet 5 1/4.
Yeah, right.
She's tall. Just kidding. You're really 5 feet 8 1/4 inches tall, which is the same as 1.73 meters.
That is exactly accurate, my friends. I'm not even kidding. That is exactly accurate. 5 foot 8. Now, I've always said it was 5 foot 8 1/2, and she said 5 foot 8 1/4. Did you see that? How accurate that is? It's not crazy accurate. Wait, I don't want to get run over. I also don't want to walk through the construction they got going on here. Hello, RWXers. Christy, how are you? Oops. We're getting down here before it gets too crazy. Well, there's light, because it's going to get dark pretty soon. Then we'll go back and get some food and see what's up with the art. Dunhill. I had a date here once. Yeah. We started building a building when you started your internship years ago. And it's still there. I had a date here once. Are they still open? This is amazing. This is like a historical hotel. Dunhill. I'm just gonna have to like I'm just gonna take a peek. This place is so cool. Look at how cool this place is. Meta's advertising. They're just getting ready for dinner hour. I'll have to come back. There's like the place where you go eat. Hey, hi. We should come back here. Oh yeah, this place is fancy, man. Name of the hotel. The Dunhill. The year is 1929, the United States is poised for what it believes to be the run of never-ending prosperity. We fought the war to end all wars. Movie makers were starting up. The location was highly envied. God, I gotta bring my wife here. She wouldn't appreciate it. She'd rather go to Oktoberfest. This is a great place to bring a date though. I'll tell you what. Great place to bring a date. Everything's open. Nothing's open normally when I do tours, so it's like really good to come tonight right now. Everything's normally closed. Also, it's dinner time. It's dinner time, so all these places that we can't normally get in and look around, they're all open right now. Vine went away. It's the old wine bar. It's not there anymore. It was used to be there when I was here. I just passed Discovery Place. Yeah. Should I turn on my location? You want me to do that? Skaters. All right. All right, my friends. Now you can do map. Now you can do the map command. Oh, I know. Yeah, I know. Yeah, yeah. Epicenter is insane. Actually, we'll go down there. We're almost there. I used to go there like and party and take, you know, my single friends and stuff. It's like everything's gone. Yeah, we got something to drink there last time. Hey, Dr. WD, how are you? Yeah, we're just walking down downtown Tryon Street. It's pretty much Main Street of Charlotte. While we still have light, now I'm gonna go back into the art show. My wife, they're having another art show today. That guy, see, he was just talking to himself. I kinda want a scooter, but it's too fast. There's a reroute over there. This is the corner. Dennis is the only thing. This is the corner that gets crazy at night, right here. The reroute. We'll come around it when we walk back the other direction. You'll see it gets pretty crazy. Like right here, it gets crazy. Prohibition is crazy. It's really pretty. I kind of want to go grab some food there, a drink or something. I'd have to tell the owner though. Let us in. Capital Grill. You did? Did you see they just came out with Action 3? I mean, I can see how the Action 2 could work. It's just, it's got a little bit too much grain for me. You know? Kind of a techie. Here's a Roxbury. This place is going to be crazy later tonight. We sat outside of it during the nighttime one day. Oh, there's a Qdoba. I could go eat there. No, I ended up buying, I ended up getting another Sony. So now I have two Sonys. I have one for home, and I, you know, and then kind of a backup. And then I have two GoPros actually too. I hate them, but it's too late. I'm gonna probably sell it or give it to my stepson or somebody. Here's the Roxbury. You know, I'm gonna go in here and talk to the owner because I really want to go in here one day. How's it going, Samaria? Oh, indoors? Yeah, if it has enough light, it seems to do fine. I actually started watching, you know, the what's his name? The bike, the moped messenger in New York. And his streams at night are okay, but then during the day are okay too. I think the action too could be a thing. I do. I think it could be a thing for action shots and stuff. I just, I don't know, man. So here's the Roxbury. It's funny. I think they. Hey, how's it going? I think they moved. I think they moved. They had another 80s club that was here for a while, and I think it moved. I think that's all that really happened. I kind of want to go in and ask. I don't think it's even ready to go into yet.
No, it's not. They're not open yet. They're not going to open until later tonight.
I really want to talk to the owners, though. Oh my god, it smells like a club right now. It's like smells like cigarette smoke and beer. and loose morals. Loose morals. Oh wow. Hey, there's a burger and whiskey bar. That, how can that possibly be bad? Oh, I want to go in there. Media channels? Still have browsers? Glad I did. Should we go get a burger and some whiskey? I kind of want to go in there. I mean, there's not enough people here to get upset yet. I just want to walk through there. Oh, you have to wait to be seated. Oh my god, this place is awesome. This place is so awesome. I don't know, should we go here? If we stay here, we're not gonna have time to go on anywhere else. Look at that chandelier, man. Oh, I'm walking around, I'll be back.
Thank you.
That place is awesome. Oh my god, that place is, I want to go there. I am hungry, but I'm not super hungry. Does that make sense? I could go with just like drinking like a whiskey instead of... I gotta go back. We have two more hours. I'm actually gonna buy some Jamaican food from the food truck outside. The Capital Grill, I will never eat there. That's like the most overpriced place. It's like a whole bunch of 1% old fogies. That whiskey bar though. McDonald's, no. You're not late for the party. We're going back. We're gonna go back to the, everybody's just coming out. That's like the evening crowd is just coming out. We're like in family friendly time right now. It's kind of like, okay, so like the vibe is like, it's totally dead at 5 o'clock because everything's closed and everybody's getting home. And then everybody gets home from work and then they all go out and eat as a family. And then the singles come out after that and things get crazy. Should we go take a trip? Hey, look, it's the funny bus. I should go get on the funny bus. This is where there's going to be a show here. We'll come back here on the other side. There's going to be a show here. Yeah. So this is actually a really good time to come. Food truck. Yeah, I'm going back to the food truck. Fahrenheit Grill on top of the skyscraper. I have it. I have not. I didn't know the name of it. I heard about it. I want to go there. We should go there. We should get a group and go. Yeah. Okay, he wants us to look at him. I told you, it's like Friday's on, man. It was getting started kind of slow, and now it's kind of getting kicking. It's kind of kicking. You know why? People are starting to eat. Okay, and here's like pretty much the center of town. This is pretty much the center of town where we're coming up to. It's got the statues in the middle and all that. Exploring as a kid? Oh, hell yeah. I did. I lived outside all day. That's how I love exploring. You know what? I love exploring, like, my own area, too. There's always, like, stuff you don't even... That's why I like geocaching so much. You go geocaching, you can find stuff that's there. He's got his dog running. His dog's keeping up. His dog's keeping up, though, man. Why does that remind me of American Psycho? That reminds me of American Psycho. Okay, so commerce. Okay, what does commerce look like? What does commerce look like? That's commerce. It's like a gold pan. You see the gold pan? Commerce. All right. What's next? Hopefully, I won't die. What's this one? Vision, I'm gonna guess vision. I'm gonna guess this one is vision. Oh, industry. So yeah, this one is industry. It's like she's like looking, but she's like looking on the shore, you know, like looking out. She's like a navigator. All right, what's this one? Hard work, labor. We're gonna say labor. You can give them a map again. Transportation? Really? I would not have guessed that. I mean, now that I think about, I don't know, Disney's Dumbo, maybe I would get it. That is transportation. Yeah. Actually, I've had a drone. I could fly a drone up there. All right, we got to figure out what the last one is, and then we'll go back. There's where the train station is down there. All right, what's the one with the naked bare nipples? Maternity? Future, of course. Of course it is. Of course it is. Of course it is, because every time I see a half-naked woman with a baby, I think of the future. That's what I think. I think of the future. There's a bus station and the train. It does have a train station, but it's not a big train station. It has max tracks. You know, like whatever the. I think this is where we started our marathon last year. Yeah, it is. Or not last year when I did it. I did the Thunder Road Marathon. We picked up our packs from here. Yeah, the Thunder Road Marathon starts from here. Because this is pretty much downtown. This is like the downtown, you know, center of town. We'll go all the way down to the NASCAR Museum and turn around. How's it going, Lemur? Where's the Liz? Because baby is future. Yeah, it's not really a bus station. I mean, it is a bus station. It is mostly a bus station, I'll give you that. It's like, they do have some, downtown is a little bit liberal, so they do have like public transportation and stuff. So that's a thing. Oh, it's like missionaries, they're like teaching and stuff. That's kind of cool. Should we go talk to the free Bible teachers? We could do that. Prime Seafood. Hey, do y'all remember the stream where we went into the Brazilian barbecue and they took us into the back room? He insisted. He's like, come back here and stream it all. What's his name? The guy in the back. Chase. It's another bank. Fun fact. I don't think anybody has to be told this. Fun fact. Not so fun fact, I guess. How are you? Not so fun fact. Charlotte is the second biggest financial sector city in the United States. New York is the first. Oh, Korean barbecue. Fuck, I could go for some of that right now. All right, let's go check this out. Man, how far? Oh, I'm just checking. I just gotta check it out. Oh, shit. It's like the real thing, man. We should come back. Oh, my God, what's that up there? Sorry. All right. Oh, we gotta come back to that. We're making like a little. Oh shit! It's got the actual grill out there. You see that? See that? They have like a grill on the table. They got a grill on the table there. There's a grill on the table. I've never had a grill on the table. Oh, I know. It smells so good. I am going back there. We gotta go all the way down and all the way back. If I stop at every place to eat, I'll never make it. You know what? I'll do a downtown Charlotte stream every month or so, every 2 months or something. There's always something. I'm always down here because my wife's art stuff is down here. You're hungry too? Nom 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 nom. This is the right time to come. People are getting back from the gym. They went to go to the gym because they got out of their job at the bank, the insurance company. And now, oh God, look at that. And then they have some drinks, and now they're getting ready to relax because it's Friday night. Like, what is this weekend gonna bring? Seafood and steaks. There's Bella Ciao. That's where we were. No, we went into Bella Ciao, and there's the one next to it. Actually, sitting down here, the Brazilian barbecue. We're almost to the end. Planet Fitness. See, if I was living out of my car, I could go in there and have a shower in Planet Fitness. Yeah, it does, actually. It does. There's a whole category for it. For the 3D panorama stuff. Yeah, there's a whole category. If you look for the tag, you have to have the right camera for it, but I don't. I don't have a camera for that. Hey, man. Starbucks, now hiring. Starbucks is hiring, guys. Starbucks is hiring. Ruth Chris's. It's like Morton Steakhouse. They are? Yeah. It's getting kind of, oh yeah, we're down by the, let's go down to the green and turn around. We'll go to the Mint Museum. The Mint Museum, where my wife had her art. She's had a show. She's had pieces in there twice now, three times. IRL streams, they're just fun. You know, what's down there? Oh, there's more pubs. Oh gosh, there's a sunset. Let's go look at the sunset. I think we could see the sunset from over here. What the hell is this? 300 South Tryon. Bearden Promenade. Hey, hi. I don't know what that is. What's Bearden Promenade? What is this? I don't know what this building is. Go get some sushi or KO sushi. I haven't been down this street before. Maybe I did. I think this might have been the return trip of the marathon. I don't know though. I can't remember. It's sunset though, so we got good light right now. Really fancy sidewalk. some construction going on over there. Angeline's. That looks fancy. Angeline's looks pretty fancy. God damn, look at that skewer. Ink Ivy. Oh, we're in Packard Place. This is where the biggest makerspace used to be. Yeah, I never actually went there before. I wonder if they reopened it after COVID. The biggest makerspace in all of Charlotte is in that building right there. At least it used to be. I think they redid it all though. I need to go figure that out. I haven't been to this part. You know what? I think I ran through here on the marathon, but that was it. Wait, I don't want to get run over. This is cool. Oh my god, there's like skate park. I haven't been here before. Bearden Park. Romary Bearden Park. Well, I want to say this stuff is pretty new. I really want to know if Packer Place has still got a makerspace. We got to go figure that out. I'm sorry, I gotta go check that out, see if they have the makerspace over there. I have to see if the makerspace is still there. It was built in 2010, that might explain it. Yeah, I think that explains it, because I think this was all built. I wanna say it was under construction during the marathon, because there was a huge parking lot that was just gravel and stuff right there. That's why I recognize it.
Please help me if you can.
So, my back is hot, but please use front entrance, exit only. There was a makerspace uptown, I'm telling you. There was a makerspace here for years. For like 4 years, and then they closed it. What the hell is this? I've never been here. Ink and Ivy. So let me go see if we can find out. I think the makerspace used to be here, and then they redid it. That's what I think happened. Yeah, I think they used to. Should I go ask the locals? Let me go ask them. Hey, can I ask y'all a question? There used to be a makerspace in here. You guys remember that, like forever ago?
You're going really far.
I know. I'm an old guy. It was like 10 years ago, right? I thought they redid it though. Didn't they ever redo it here? Did they move it or something? No idea.
It's all good. Too far back.
Yeah. I mean, that whole thing it was like all construction back time when I was. That was like X-10 or something.
Without a doubt, this was not what it is now.
Yeah.
No,
I was like, I don't recognize any of that. Yeah, I am. I'm about 10, 20 years old, but I'm just back to say hi. I'm just visiting.
Like 5 years ago.
Oh, is it really? 6 years ago?
Something like that?
Yeah. All right. All good. Well, I'm just Twitch streaming, but you're good. You're not on, so.
See ya.
Hey, thank you, sir.
No problem.
Thank you.
What is that?
I'm just streaming. Just doing some live streaming with my friends.
Copy. I like it.
My wife's down. She's at an art show right now. So I was like, get out here while it's sunny. This whole place is new to me. I was here like 10 years ago, and I remember that got rebuilt, and there used to be like a computer maker space here. Y'all remember that?
I've only been here almost 3 months.
3 months.
So I'm not really familiar there.
Yeah.
Guys, come straight in.
Thank you, sir.
It's a fantastic space here.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. I'm going to be back.
Oh, it's beautiful scenery.
I'll be back.
And the food is great.
I have no doubt. It's like, I just want to go in there and live in there, but I got to...
Yeah, you got to work.
See ya. Take care. Oh man, we just found the G-Gen area. You guys know about this? It's like an IRL thing. I have TTS of your messages, yeah, but I turned it off. I turned TTS off because people use it. Sorry. So there's a kind of a popular, I don't even know what the term actually means, but I've seen it on three IRL streams now. People call it degen. They call it like degen alley. It's like where you go to get the party, wherever the party's going down. Like Rob CG goes there. How do you know where to cover the cam? Because I have a big old cam coming off my shoulder. Oh, are you talking about when do I cover it and when do I not? Yeah, just like the time you guys tried. Yo! The garbage guys are happy. That was the garbage guys. They're like, yo, what's up? There was one time, I kid you not, I had the same voice for TTS as Android for navigating. And they were like trying to get me to navigate wrong. It was so funny. Yeah, look, people are like dumping in here because they're coming down for evening. Like the evening's just getting started. This family doesn't want to be filmed. I'm not going to film. That's how you know. You can kind of get a vibe for it. You kind of know it's going to go down like that. Don't turn our shit into each other. Wait, were you there for that? Were you there when I got that drunk? And I went in, put the camera up. I'm so glad I put the camera up. To be fair, I turned my stream off. And then I clicked it one too many times, and so it turned right back on again. It went off, and then it went right back on. And I'm like, oh shit. I was like looking at my monitor, and I was like, uh-oh. Oh my God, it's so nice and cool now. This is the time to come out and go for a walk, you know? We're gonna have some really great streaming later.
Here?
Kind of thing.
We just hit this side,
conmigo. Vaya conmigo. Vaya conmigo. I understood that part. Vaya conmigo. Damn, I wanna eat. This guy's gonna run me over, watch. Thought I have a camera on. I have a dash cam. So when he runs me over. Can you blackout jet and retrace your steps to the bottom? Yeah, it is. I've done it a couple times. One time I slept in my car. Only once. There's only once. One time I got so drunk I didn't want to drive home. It would have been unsafe. So I slept in my car. I'll never do that again though on stream. That's like so dangerous. Seriously, like sleeping, telling everybody you're going to sleep in your car while you're live streaming. How stupid can you be? I will never do that again. If I do that again, you gotta call Doris and tell her where I am. And she'll come get me like always. Because she loves me. She doesn't judge. She's like, whatever. She's the best, man. Like, oh, Rob. Oh, Rob. Damn, I want to eat at all of these restaurants. I am so hungry. I didn't realize I was this hungry. Yeah, the bathroom is the worst part. Yeah, you gotta get like a membership at like a Planet Fitness or something like that, and you gotta learn how to live out there. So this is where we went. This is where they invited us anytime we want to come back. Remember we went in here and I was like all nervous? I went in here and I was all nervous and the owner like grabbed me and said, here, come check this out, come in the back and everything. I wonder if he's still there. You can't go in here unless you have proper dress, which we do. Dude, this place is awesome. I want to come back here so bad. He personally invited us, the owner of that place personally invited us back. I want to come back, like with a gang. Seriously, we got to get like, okay, so the rest of you who live here, we have to like meet up and we have to go there because he was so nice to us. There we go. Woo! I guess Friday is getting going. I didn't say 100, but you know, it's a figure of speech. Figure of speech. That guy looked like a dwarf. He was huge. Oh, I know. Brazilian steakhouse is... I've only been to one. That's why I want to go. I mean, you'll have to, like, plan a whole day after that because you have to, like, sleep it off. I seriously, if you eat that much meat, you have to, like... I think we should. We should. I want to... Yeah. I have to go back. I got my lady. I still think this thing reminds me of a Cylon or an Independence Day UFO. Every time I say it. Yo! What's up, huh?
Quick question.
Yeah, live stream. Y'all good? What are you doing there? Nature Conservancy, nice!
Yeah. Have you heard of us?
Well, yeah.
How'd you hear about us?
You're like a big deal.
Yeah, very big deal.
Since the 1970s. Yeah,
1951.
What the hell? Yeah. Really? I did not know that. You're on Twitch, that's cool.
Yeah.
Oh, how many God. We got today? Not that
hey,
many.
Twitch family.
Like 40 people
hey,
or so.
Twitch family. Check us out online.
Oh, yeah, free ads.
Follow
go
me
check
on
it.
Instagram.
Bear oh, yeah. Okay, do you have a card? Like,
we don't have nothing you can take because we're trying to save the trees.
Yeah. That makes a lot of sense. Y'all are smart.
Yeah.
Y'all are smart.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, are you live?
Yeah. What's up?
Nah, what's up, Twitch?
Yeah, they're crazy. I'm doing an art stream. I go in. My wife's in a show down here. Okay. So.
Oh, man, shout out New Orleans.
All right. See you, man.
Guys.
All right. Those guys are awesome. Those guys are awesome. I'll go film them. The Bible people over there. I'm not so sure the reaction would be the same if I were to go over there. You dare me to go talk to the Bible people and say I was Mormon for 42 years? What do you think they would say? How many bits to do that? How many bits to do that? How many bits to go introduce myself to the Bible missionaries as a Reformed Mormon? As a Reformed Mormon, I need motivation though. I am not doing that. I'm gonna take a beating, man. I don't know if there's enough bits in the world to make me do that. I'm not even drunk. If I was a little more drunk, I might. Of course, I'm zero drunk, so. It's always the same food truck there, too. It's always the same food truck right there. Sometimes I wonder if they like, just permanently like, fuck it, content. Everything is content. Everything is content. Everything is content. Hey, that guy's. Look at that guy. The guy wheeling. Did you see that? Oh, okay. The only way I am ever going to get a scooter is if it has kick-ass runner lights like those scooters, man. Those are the only scooters to ever get. Right there. I mean, check that. Taking a beating equals great content. I don't know about that. That's the only way to ride, right there.
That's how you do it, man.
Where are they?
They're called Cabo Mantis. The plane is called Cabo.
Cabo?
Cabo, like K-A-A-B-O.
Yeah, yeah.
They go like 40 miles an hour.
Oh, man. So they're renters?
No, we own them.
Oh, you, okay, I'm find it. Oh, man, that's awesome. They actually bought those things. Did you see that? Those are awesome. That guy's cool, man. They live there in downtown. See, that's how you do it, man. You get yourself a... I'm talking like a boomer. I don't care. Ouch. I just smacked my phone on the thing. Okay, so this is the highbrow stuff. We're coming up to highbrow stuff. This is where the performing arts are. My wife had an installation here a while ago. Let's go see what's playing. Let's go see what's playing. Yelling at strangers. Oh, I can yell at strangers. It's Friday night. Hi. You don't have to be that. They get it. Anastasia. That's like a terrible story. How did they possibly make a thing out of it? Her whole family dies, spoiler alert. And then she gets stuck off to be an orphan. How can you make a musical out of that? They make musicals out of everything, I guess. Hadestown, they're gonna bring Book of Mormon here, and I'm gonna go see that when they come. They haven't had anything here. And well, my wife had an installation piece right there when they did the play last time. So. You want to see Die Hard? There's a Die Hard musical. There's actually a musical called Die Hard? There's a musical called Die Hard. You gotta be kidding me, really? That's insane. I did not know that. Yo, what's up?
Is it like a GoPro?
Sony, yeah. A little bit better than a GoPro, tightly. Oh my god. Ladies' night on the town. Do you see that? You know you want me to follow that. There's like 12, it's like a bachelorette party. There's literally 20 women walking to the Roxbury at the same time. Oh, there's so much people. Dude, you see that? It's like a pack. It's like a pack of hotties, like, walking around. Yellow stuff. Yeah. You gotta see up here. Alright, we gotta go exploring. We're in Prohibition. We're in Prohibition. We gotta go back. We only have 2 hours left in the art thing. I've never been up here, though. I've never been up here. It's Skyrim vibes. Skyrim vibes again. Oh my god, look at that hood. Oh my god, look at it up here. Look at this place. Oh my god, this place is crazy cool. You know what? This is where they had the show. This is where they had an open mic. They used to have a stage back here. Oh yeah, this turns into a dance place. They got a DJ going on. They must put the tables back. Because when I was here, it was a dance place. They had a band back here. When I was here, they used to have a band back here. Didn't y'all used to have a stage here once upon a time?
I'm sorry?
Didn't you used to have like a live band stage? I swear I came here to a performance once upon a time.
So I know.
I mean, is this new? This is original?
Yeah, pre COVID, they did have a different setup. Yeah. They had a DJ booth over there.
Yeah.
And a bar over in that corner. And so they probably did do a few live bands over here.
And then this one doesn't open out to the balcony. That's Re-Rock, right?
Yeah, Re-Rock over there opens up to the balcony. Yeah. The only balcony we have is that
and
one.
And you guys, like, you guys pull these in when it gets crazy? You pull the tables down?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll have to come back without the camera. See ya. When I was here last time, the bartenders were like getting beat up, man. They were getting so beat up because it was like six deep to get booze. God, I gotta bring my wife back here. I really want to bring her back here. I had drinks with Doris here once. I remember. That was a long time ago, though. It was like so long ago. That's so long ago. Don't leave here without a drink. We're gonna get ladies for us. It's called ladies. Hey, look. This is a good vantage point. This is a good vantage point. Should I go get a drink? What should I get? I have about an hour left. I kind of want a drink. Can I get a drink? I'll buy a drink. Because I have to. You can't come in here and like, what's wrong with you? I gotta get something. Hey, hi. Hi, can I get a... I've got a while, so... What do you got? You got White Zombie?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, how about that? This is the time to come here. It's gonna get crazy later. staring down at peasants. You gonna take a Manhattan? It's too early for a Manhattan. I'm supposed to be someplace else. So I have to close it, I'm afraid, tonight. When is the dance starting? Dancing start? Come back without the camera.
Dance.
Do they do like DJ stuff and all that? Starting when?
10 p.m. But they usually start to get busy around midnight.
Around midnight? Yeah, that sounds about right. I'm not drinking early. I'm taking shit from Twitch. I'm gonna run out of battery here, guys. Damn. All right. Thank you. I just noticed my phone's almost dead. Yeah, I'm gonna have to charge it up. I got it. Here, give me a sec. Oh, see, they're leaving, and I was gonna come out here now. I'm sorry. I was trying. I'm sure they don't want me to be here. Oops, I'm drinking, spilling beer, spilling precious beer there. Need more battery. I have a ton of battery packs. I just need to plug it in. I need a cable to plug it in. We'll probably be fine. Because I turned off all the streaming shit. Let me turn off the relocator. My wife says she has a drink ticket. She said like an hour ago, she says she has a drink ticket. My wife, she's like, I have a drink ticket. Meanwhile, my phone's gonna die. I'm not gonna be able to talk to anybody. All right, it's time to shut everything down. Matt, how are you? Oh man, this is the perfect time to be here because you can get all these people still here. Hey, there's a piece of weed in my beer. Peasants. I was just really thirsty. Here comes another scooter. Did you see those two scooters? Those two scooters were actually owned by the people there. That's why they had the LEDs on the bottom. I was like, those are so cool. How about those Nature Conservancy people? Those are people who are pretty awesome, huh? I thought they were pretty damn awesome. They were really friendly. One gas server. I don't know about that, man. I don't know about that. Yeah, those Nature Conservancy guys are awesome. I'm like, do you have a card? And like, he probably gets asked that all the time. I asked him, I said, do you have a card or a pamphlet? He goes, no, because trees. Yo, skate or die, dude. We're running down from the Roxbury. Oh, I can't drink beer all the time, but Every once in a while. Dance club, right here, we're in it. Like, right down the street, this is the Roxbury. There's like an 80s and 90s place down the street that I want to go to. But I want to go to it, I gotta get permission from the owner. I can't, and I just want to go in a corner someplace. What the hell is that? Park it. Just getting back, they're just getting back from a play or something. Yeah, they're getting back from a play. Oh, that guy's got a one wheel. I need to get a monowheel. I want one so bad. That guy, sometimes he's here, he'll have a flag dangling off of him. Now look at those guys, they're totally dressed up. These guys are totally dressed up. They're dressed for Friday night. You know what? I like this time of night. What time is it? And you know what it is? It's because everybody's not pissed drunk yet. They're like all just dressed up and fresh and out for a walk, and you got like family out. People are going to the play. And then you got Morty. Morty, this is the best time to make a cultural assessment, Morty. It's like right at sunset before anything gets too crazy, Morty. It's a universal constant throughout the universe, Morty. After five beers, everybody gets crazy no matter where you are. No. It's chill right now. Streaming in a bathroom? I streamed in a bathroom on accident, but it was like a real big accident. Of course, I didn't stream anything while in the bathroom. We'll save the barmaid some work. Thank you very much. Oh God, that was good. Hit the spot, man. Hit the spot. Third episode out yet? No, I don't think it is. Adam Savage. I look pretty much like Adam Savage. If I... See, look. Whoa. I need to do Adam Savage. I have to be more squeaky if I'm going to do Adam Savage. Yeah. All right, there we go. We're ready to go. I don't like two word. Too weird. No drinks past this point by a penalty of death. But you can be drunk. You just have to have the drinks in your body. You're gonna do that. No cowboy hat today. Re-Raw. This thing is so amazing. You know what? We'll come in here another night. We'll come into Re-Raw another night. That's my favorite pub in all of Charlotte. It also burned down. Morty. I'm what they call a high-functioning alcoholic, Morty. It means I can have, like, intense thoughts and philosophy. I can have sex with full planets and yet still drink soda. Oh, hey, it's that guy again. We met him last time. They're doing a tour. They only had, like, four people that time, though. Yeah. I'm a cyborg. It's my laser. Oh, God, there's an actual art gallery. Look at that. Look at that. The generosity of Bank of America. Should we go in there? It's actually open right now. We got a tour over here going on. All right. We gotta hook up with that tour one of these days. Yeah, I can do a proper tour. But denied. Thank you. I was denied. We gotta come back though. Look how pretty it is in there. Look at that, man. We gotta come back when they're open. This is fucking amazing. I wonder if my wife knows this show is going on. She's into the glass stuff. She used to date a glass blower. That's not a joke. It's the truth. You need me to what? The tour guy? Shoulder mount. Yeah, I stole the shoulder mount for the Predator. It's like a laser mount. Where's my skateboard when I need it? You know, sometimes I don't bring my skateboard because they like freak people up. Other times I'm like, why do I not have my skateboard? 5'8" and 1/4. So that computer over there has corrected my height. I always thought I was 8.5 inches tall. 5'8.5", and I've since been corrected by the laser precision accurate Discovery Zone thing. See, that's the guy over there. See him standing there? Tell him how tall he is. He makes the same stupid joke every time. Hey, look. It's the building you should live in if you want to stream. Random neon in the background.
Did you make her buy the shoulder mount?
No. I mean, it's pretty standard IRL rig. I have a, you know... Whoa, that's like a powered skateboard. Shit. I want that skateboard so bad. I'm so jealous. What was I gonna say? So, yeah, this is like the perfect time. We have to come downtown more this early because it's like, it's nice and cool, but there's still enough light to kind of stream shit and people are doing stuff already. And they're not like crazy ass, like crazy, like really crazy. You know how they get, right? No, the shoulder mount is a stuntman. Oh, yeah, it's a stuntman, Morty. They make these mounts. All right, this place gets crazy. Like right now, it's not crazy, but it gets like really crazy. When does it get crazy? Midnight, 11?
Sorry.
This place gets pretty crazy, but I noticed that it's like, not got many people in here tonight. When does it get active? It's kind of early, yeah. Yeah. Cellar. I've never been there before. Hi. I'm just on reconnaissance. This is very conservative, like sports bar. Like a sports bar. Yeah. It's just a sports bar with a kitchen. Oh, yeah. Can I walk around down there? Yeah. Oh, God. Let's see what's going on. Hiya. I'm just doing reconnaissance. What's up? Is that a restaurant over there?
Yes.
Yeah. Can I take a shot of it really quick?
You can take a look in, but it's very tight in there.
Yeah, I don't want to mess with people. Yeah. I just want to look really quick. Shit. There's a lot of people in there. Yeah, it's cool. Cool. Thank you. We gotta come back here too. Yeah. We gotta come back here too. Boop, boop, boop. That place is fucking packed because everybody's eating dinner and then they come, then they go upstairs and they're like, seriously, there's like 40 people and like, there's like 40 people outside here usually. Let's go over here. Go back over here. There's usually like 40 people over there. I'm telling you. Uh-oh. Should have dressed up like a camera like a parrot. I just read that. That is brilliant. I'm gonna do that. My wife's a sculptor. I'm gonna make a parrot. I'm gonna make a fucking parrot on my shoulder. They'll just think I'm crazy. I mean, I don't care if they think I'm some wacko lunatic. I don't care about that. I don't want them to know I have a camera.
You know what? There's no other way to know. There's like, sure, there's like a cable going into it, but they would never know. I could put the like a camera like in the belly or something. That is such a good idea. Name that guy. Oh, I get nicknamed that guy all the time. Do you think I give a shit? My wife's exact word for me is shameless. Police don't care, man. Unless you cause trouble, you're making the world a better place. My Euro days. Seriously, you don't understand. When I IRL stream, I mostly stream art. So, because I'm streaming art, I could put a parrot on my shoulder and wear like a pirate bandana, and everybody would totally not even buck. They're like, oh, look at that esoteric, weird performance art guy over there. Seriously, you should see the things that people wear to like regular art openings. People wear the craziest shit to art openings. Artists are so expressive and awesome, and they do have no shits to give. They're like, oh yeah, it's a part of my self-expression. I'm not even kidding. We're going to say hi to my wife. It would be weird to hide the camera. Yeah, I honestly, that's the hardest part of it. I believe it or not, at first I was like, hey, I want a camera that's black because people wouldn't notice it. And then I realized that you actually want people to notice the camera. You want them to. You know why? Because then you can see the reaction. Like, for example, when I was outside of the Duckworth, that woman that I kind of kept off camera, she was like looking away. She did not want to be in the camera, you could tell. Like, really didn't want to be in the camera. And so I covered the lens. It's not illegal to film her, but I covered the lens. She's in public grounds. But so you kind of get a sense of like, and then you run into other people who are like those Nature Conservancy guys, and like, hey, Twitch, what's up? And they're like totally like screwing around, right? You just don't know what you're gonna run into. And so you kind of have to read the room, right? Or read the person. And by having a camera like explicitly on your shoulder, and everybody knows it's a camera, is actually good. Because they see you walking up, and they start to react to you based on, I mean, this is my over analytical opinion of the whole thing. They see the camera and they immediately form an opinion about you, and they start to behave a certain way, and you want to know right away what they think of that. If they think it's really cool, great. If they think it's terrifying, or they think that I'm some like cuck who, you know, can't get it or whatever, you know, that's a different thing. Yeah. Too bad. Yeah, I don't do that. When I hide the camera, all I'm doing is covering the camera. And all I'm doing is just showing respect. It's like, I mean, look, anything they say, everybody can hear it. People are totally okay with being heard, unless you're like recording their private conversation. They're not okay with being, their picture being filmed. They're not okay with that. Some people are. This is something I found. I've been doing this now for what, 6 months? It's been really fun. It's kind of a fun sociological study in how people behave, because everybody's different, you know. And my regular crew, you know, the art people that I hang out with, some of them don't like to be filmed, some do, and so I'm careful. Doris hates it. Doris hates to be on camera. Anytime Doris willingly walks on camera, especially in her PJs with no bra like she did the other day, you know that she's like really sacrificing for me, because she's like, I didn't even ask her to. She just came and gave me a hug.
How you doing, dude?
What's up?
How you got to Church Street?
Church Street? You know what? I do not know. I'm so sorry.
What was it, Marriott? We got a Marriott on that island.
Marriott? I really don't know. I should probably know that. Yeah. Do you have the maps and all that going on, yeah?
Yeah, because that, you know, the truck is big. I cannot keep
it. Oh, I know. It would be crazy. And it's going to get crazier tonight.
Yeah.
Too. Yeah, I would. I don't know. I really don't. I'm guessing it's like right downtown though, because it's a pretty big hotel right downtown in the middle, and it is pretty busy down there. So I would make sure to figure that out. Best of luck, my dude.
No problem. Thank you.
See you. Dude, he's got to get that thing. He's got to pull that thing into the Marriott, which is downtown. That's like real. That's like real work, man. Truck driver earning his money, man. Yeah. Threatened regarding filming? Not yet. Zooming in to some weird part of my body. Sorry. Oh my god, that's pretty terrifying. I don't know if this woman was. Oh, she's filming downtown Charlotte. I don't think she wants me to film her. Here's the Charlotte Ballet. Look at that picture, man. So fucking awesome. I'll take that over a cheerleader any day. Oh, my phone just died. I can't even hear what you're saying. I gotta go charge it up. I'm gonna stream you, but I honestly have no idea way of knowing what you're saying. I have no way of knowing what you're saying right now. I can't even control my camera unless I pull the power. God damn, look at all the people who are here. I'm gonna go charge it up. I'll go charge my phone. My god, they got more people than they've ever had here before. They don't normally have this many people here. Alright, I gotta go find my wife. Remember it was like totally dead before and now it's like this.
I'm a Virgo, my sign's compatible. We gon' get along just fine.
I have $5 for a beer, $10 for a wine. Wine is twice as much as beer. Sounds about right. How's it going? Hey, I've met you somewhere. Where did I meet you before? I met you. Where did we meet? I've seen you before. I'm Doris's husband.
Doris
Kapner. She's on the third floor up here.
Okay.
Were you at the show with the skater? What's his name?
Eric?
Yeah, I think it's
Eric Chang.
I want to say, I don't know. I swear I've seen you at your show before.
I know your face. You're very familiar.
Yeah, you hang at the art stuff, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know I bumped into you before, my dude. I'm going to go check on my wife upstairs, but we'll say hi. I cannot remember his name. I know that guy. I've seen him at other art stuff. I have. Oh, they didn't blow the... Alright, so this is the show we're supposed to be covering. You know what? Let's go upstairs and we'll cover it from there after we get upstairs. I gotta go find my wife. Oh, they brought dogs. It's dog friendly. Hey, there's Miles stuff. No, that's not Miles stuff. Where's Miles stuff? We're gonna see all this stuff. This is why we came. We came to go check out all this stuff. This is the art show. But I can't see my phone because my phone's dead. So I gotta go charge my phone. It's the only thing I didn't charge. I charged everything else. I kinda hurried because I had a lot of work today to do. Work is crazy right now. Really crazy. We're making this API to talk to PBS batch processes. And I'm also trying to keep the Kubernetes stuff going and stuff. And clean it all up. We had two people leave. Anyway, my sob story. Let's see if my wife's around, huh? Hopefully I smell good. Guess I want. Oh look, Taylor, is that Taylor's? It is Taylor. We gotta go talk to Taylor later. Taylor's Doris, one of Doris's good friends. She's an artist in residence here as well. Oh god, she's like really busy. Alright, we gotta figure this out. She's like busy talking to people. Should we go pick up her? Should we spy on her? Should we spy on her? Pretend like you're not there, okay? just all busy. She's all busy talking to people. This is Nell. Nell's awesome. Oh, Nell's really awesome. God damn, everybody's busy tonight. This is awesome. Alright, I gotta get out of her face. She's doing her thing, man. She's like really busy. She's busy. And this is Lauren. Lauren does the stained glass. Alright. Lauren, where's Lauren? She's not here. What the hell? She's supposed to be here. It's like an opening. Have 91% in there. Oh shit. It's the wrong kind of plug, goddammit. I probably have a plug in my car. Should we go check? It's crazy and clean. Also, I hope there's not a TOS violation for showing boobs or something.
No.
All right. Well, I am out of battery.
Oh.
So I am like being a voyeur.
I won't be able to go outside.
I know. I already went to the reroute, so this would be number two.
Well, you could just bring me something.
Well, sure. What would you like? That's good. It's like $10 for wine and $5 for
well,
beer.
Well, this was a free wine.
There's free wine?
Yeah, that was before the igniters. We could have the free wine.
All right. Well, we can't take any input from anyone because I don't have a phone that works.
Yeah, and the cord I have for the phone, for the speaker, doesn't work on phones.
Oh, God.
It's not the right.
I need USB-C.
You are holding cord.
Hello.
Have you been
yeah, oh, I know. I recognize you somehow. I don't know where.
I'm an artist.
Oh, okay.
She's an amazing artist.
I actually recognize somebody else from outside that was...
She's been at several things, I think, we went to.
Yeah, we've probably bumped into each other. I'm horrible at remembering all that. I'm trying, though.
He's live streaming.
I am going to stream over here, though. I won't stream.
I was in residence here last
summer. Oh, were you? Okay.
Yeah.
I remember that.
Yeah, so I was like hidden away in the studio on the first floor.
That's how it goes.
Well, they were just trying to figure out what the hell they were doing.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, they really...
Just, like, improvising.
Yeah.
It was a nice space.
It was.
Oh, yeah.
It's a great space.
How many millions of
people? All right, I'll come back. See you. All right, we gotta go. We are not allowed. I have no way to know. Is it live stream or fail? I forgot my phone charger. I'm gonna go in the car and see if I have a phone charger in there. I'm pretty sure I do. And then we'll try this again. We have an hour left. We have an hour left, but they do these every month, so. God, there's a lot of people in this one today. There was not nearly this many people here last time. Yeah. My wife's like, get the fuck out. That's her code for get the fuck out. She's like, she's been helping me understand when she's like, stay away completely. She's like, go back to your pub. I'm not even kidding. I love her to death, but she's very, you know. I can't even see what you're saying. I imagine you're having all kinds of fun right now. But I can't read it. It's kind of interesting, actually. It's like, I'm gonna go to the car, and I'm gonna see if I have a charger in the phone. If I have a charger cable, I can plug it right into the, I can plug it into the battery that I have. But. God damn, this place is popping, man. We gotta come back here. It's like, it's so cool out. It's, you know what it is? It was hot before. It was like really, really hot before. And it's like everything is cooled off. Everything's cooled off. He played, I know where it was now. That guy played at the pub. He played at the pub. At the old town public house where we saw the jazz. That was him, he was there. That's where I recognize him from. Oh my God, I want some of that food so bad. But I'm gonna get a cable so I can talk to you because I can't hear what you're saying right now. Man, you know what? I am so excited for the fall because the fall is cool. It's cool outside. It's not all hot. So it's going to be the downtown activities are going to be so much more fun because it's once it cools off, everybody comes out, you know, you get to meet all kinds of cool people. I'm going to get one over. What are you doing, dude? And it was the Vapa Center. This is another art center. They have a thing every month as well, so we get to go check that out. don't make jokes about me while I can't respond. It's not fair. It's not fair. It's not fair. It smells like cigars and air freshener. That's what that car smelled like. Oh my God, look at that. Look at that silhouette. Why is it all pastel colors? That's not even panther colors, what the hell? Maybe it is. Here we are. Hi. I have food in. What is this? Wait. We have shorts for some reason. There it is. Charging cable. Booyah. I am not a total fail. I'm mostly a fail, but not a total fail. This has sardines in it. Oh my God, I am so happy. All right, now I can plug that in. And I can talk to you again and sit and eat. You can, like, make fun of me. It tends to be the most popular thing to do. Damn it, where's my key? Damn it. All right, Rob. Stay focused. Stay focused. There, now I can go. Otherwise, it's gonna get ripped off. God, look at how pretty it is. Should we just tailgate here for a second? How about that? How about we just tailgate for a second? Because it's so beautiful out right now. I need to bring a barbecue. Yeah. I should bring like a whole bed back here. Just like hang out and, you know, chill. Just chill. All right, so what am I doing? I am going to plug in this cable to my phone. Does this have a light? And that would be ideal. Does it have a light? Okay. Yes, it does have a light. Okay. So you see that right there? That right there is the fan cable. We're going to pull the fan cable out. And we're going to plug in the phone charger. People talking. lots of work there. I must have bumped the cable because I didn't unplug it, but it was enough to kill the camera. Dude, there's like a huge parade of like Latin pride. I'm pride parade. Go ahead. Yeah, it's like they're having like their own makeshift parade. I love it. The camera's not pointing anywhere. It was on the ground. It's like, is this a Mexican flag, right? Hey, hey! Hey! I love it. They're like having an impromptu parade. I love it. It's like a huge parade of like Latin pride. It's like Latin pride here. Look at that. They got like a huge Latin pride parade. It's like awesome. Yay. Yeah. Driving's gonna be a pain in the ass though. I wonder what this cop up here thinks of all this. Like Latin pride. Woo! Yay! Yay! Yeah! I love it! I love it! Latin pride, baby! Oh my god, this is like a great night. This is like a fantastic night. I'm like so happy about this. Check it out. See, like, this is totally impromptu. Dude, there must be like 2 miles of Latin Pride Parade going on. Look at them. Yeah, yeah. That looks like this is actually in Mexico. And they're just having fun. I mean, I wonder how they organized. It reminds me of Arizona. Friend is in him, get a drink. You want to get a drink now? I gotta get my wife a drink. I gotta get her some wine. I don't know what she wants though. I have to text her. Let's go see what kind of wine she wants. I'm asking my wife what drink she wants. Yeah, pride. God, they got some. You know, I won't lie. Woo! I won't lie. Yay! This is like something I like about America, as it's like. I do. I like that. There's like so many different cultures, and that they actually really take pride in it. And most of them do it without getting racist. Not always. Mexican Independence Day is today. Today is Mexican Independence Day. I did not know that. I knew that there was Latin Pride this week, but I didn't know that today was Mexican Independence Day. Yeah. Wow, so they're like taking the street. They're like, we are gonna make this our own parade. Check that out, man. I love it. I used to live in Arizona. I used to live in Arizona, and I did not remember. I love it. I love it. I mean, how would it be to be in like another country and like just say, hey, we're gonna celebrate our country Independence Day whether you want us to or not. I think it's so great. I think it's fantastic. The cop sitting there like, oh, what's up? The cop's like, what's up?
What do they have? Yeah, you should not be stopping in the middle of the intersection. That's probably not cool. I agree. Oh God, look at this silhouetted church. That's the McColl Center. See that window up there? That's where we were. We were up at the top window. That's where my wife is. There's a special office in the tower, in the bell tower. Yeah. All right, we have to go. We're on a mission. And now the new quest is give my wife food. I mean alcohol. We have to get my wife some alcohol. Get some alcohol for my wife. I don't think that's the free wine. I think that's the wine we have to pay for. That guy is from the other bar. That's how I know him. I have to put y'all back on my wrist again. That's how I know the band, because he's a drummer. He drums for the local pub in the area. So it's like. There's a lot of alcohol out here. The museum is special, yeah. This is the McColl Center. We're gonna cover this now completely, but I'm gonna get some wine to take to my wife, and then we'll go through. My wife is allergic to fish, so she can't just drink any alcohol. And I think I still have the ticket. Mexican Independence Day. I knew it was National Hispanic Heritage Month. I did not know it was a Mexican Independence Day today. Hi there. I'm on assignment to bring this to my wife. To redeem it.
To redeem it, you redeem it over there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you're close.
All right. My wife is saying, what do they have? She's allergic to fish.
I don't have any fish. I have Sauvignon Blanc, I have Rosé, I have Chardonnay.
She probably won't be okay with any of that unless she checks Barnivore.
Checks the bottle?
Barnivore, because they put ice in glasses and stuff. Is that Hazy?
Hazy IPA.
I don't think she likes IPA, but... I don't know, man. Let me ask her really quick. I have a couple brands that I know that you can pay with. So, just check. It's weird.
This song is called Back to Reality.
So some wine contains fish?
Making you feel like you're...
If it's been produced in a facility that's anywhere near Isenglass. So Isenglass is regularly used in German stuff. So yeah.
Thank you.
You want that one? I don't know, man. I don't know. I'll, yeah, I got it. Yeah, I did. Let me right back in. Yeah, the German beer has German purity laws, so that's never a problem. But my wife had to be really careful with. You like the art streams? Oh, I love them too. They'll be on Fridays and Saturdays and that kind of thing. We're going to do Oktoberfest. We're going to go to Oktoberfest on Sunday. I don't know what to get her, man. I always hate that. You know what? She's got red wine at home. Oh, you're fine. I'm just still looking here. I think the hazy IPA is something she can think
of. Well, there's one other beer they had in here.
Hey, you were in Davidson last night. You were. Yeah, get around. We're starting to get to know the catering people. They were at the same event. I'm Rob. PM me? What'd you do? You have something to tell me? I don't know. I gotta get a.
Did you say something about a beer and kissing your wife?
Yeah. Same one. Yeah. Which is interesting because if you're gonna be at these events, she's always there. So if I could figure out what the choices are in advance, it would be easier on her. Because
she's all different selection
and every time. Yeah, I don't know what she was drinking for. She was. I'm actually going to take her ticket. I'll buy her a drink. Daddy, I'll buy her. She'll die. She goes into anaphylactic shock with even a smell of it. We've had to EpiPen her twice before just from like a little dose of it. She's really, really sensitive to it. Hey, in case you guys don't know, so Rob here was at the Davidson event last night as well. I'm live streaming, that's why. I'm telling him the story that I am. So yeah, he was here. I know, I need to get her a flask. They got a great band tonight, man. This band is kick-ass. Alright. I'm gonna command decision. I'll drink the beer and then I'll buy her something. And we'll do it that way.
Chardonnay, right?
Oh, is it Chardonnay? Okay, yeah, fine. You know what? I'll take her to Chardonnay and I'll see you. If it doesn't work, I'll drink it. When do you? Okay, thank you. Chardonnay, man. Chardonnay always tastes like butter to me. I don't know about you, but it tastes like butter to me. Chardonnay always tastes like butter. It's what they use for cooking and stuff. I know, we need to get Doris a flask and she can bring her own stuff. I need to, you know what? I'm gonna bring the flask for her. I'm gonna be her manager. Like I was handing out cards all day yesterday. Let me go see if she can take it. Hey, hi. How are you? What? Oh, how's it going, my friend? I'm on Twitch. There's like.
Oh, you're on Twitch?
Yeah, we're under the art category. We're streaming right now.
Okay. What's your username?
Well.
Whatever you call it.
Sometimes it's RWXROB. But it gets pretty crazy in there.
Don't worry,
I'm a pusher. I may have gotten drunk on vodka and taped my nipples once upon a time. Yeah, that was a long time. There's no evidence of it, but you know, it's Twitch. You know, just Twitch, you know what I'm saying. Yeah, I'm Marta Ochoa. Tell us who you are. We'll shout you out.
Can I do that? Yes, I'm Alexandra. I'm not on Twitch right now.
Oh, aren't you? But can we SO you?
Sure.
What's your username, if you don't mind my saying?
I don't even remember what it is on Twitch.
Well, if you go find it, let us know. We'll shout you out, and then people can link to you, and then go watch you and stuff.
Rex with two X's.
Yeah? Yeah, we could try it. Yeah, I know. It's a total dumpster fire over there. Twitch is a dumpster fire. I actually started doing it because I was teaching coding, and then COVID. I was teaching it one-on-one, and then I went online. Yeah, and I do the full-time thing, help people get jobs and stuff. And my wife's an artist, so I said, let's do this IRL. Doris.
Oh my God, okay. I've never heard you before.
Yeah, I'm the crazy... Yeah, I have to be told to tone it down on occasion.
That's funny, because I always tell people when I come in here, I'm like, I'm ready to torture some artists. Like, I just walk up in their space and I'm like, let me film you.
Wait, who you are?
I'm the digital media coordinator.
Oh, I've heard all about you.
Oh, because,
yeah,
that's
so like, Doris is like, oh my God, she like used my thing. You know, she gets super excited.
She's great. I love how involved she is and everything. And she's my job.
She posted my new mug today.
She did?
Oh, I haven't
Did you?
That.
Oh, did you buy the fuck mug? You bought it? Did you buy it or make it?
No, I told her I will buy that.
I was gonna buy it.
She's like, I was like test run and stuff like that. I will buy it.
Yeah.
Like 100%.
So she has to make more. Tell her that.
But she
I need a fucked up mug.
She would not take my money because she was just like, you saved me from locked closets more times than I can count. So I was like,
she's like crazy. She'll come do a doodle on my whiteboard while I'm streaming and they're like, nobody touched the doodle. Because it's like, you know, it's like
work
worse than, better than anything I would ever do.
Yeah.
I know. It's like, it's crazy being married to her, but she's fun. This is supposed to be her wine, so.
Let's see.
She's loaded. All right, see you. There's a bug in her wine. We can't have that. Oh, man, I've never actually met them. Mark? Hey, Mark. How's it going in North Carolina? How do I help them get jobs if they don't have a CS degree? I make contacts. People get jobs because people trust you. They don't get jobs because you have a degree. So that's the secret. It's just still nice and cool. This Chardonnay is really nice and cool. It's very refreshing. Yes? Wait, is she there? Is RWX's wife there? Oh, damn it. Okay, I'm gonna have to, you know what, I'm just gonna fucking buy her a beer. I'm just gonna fucking buy her a beer. Because she's got people here and stuff. I've gotta be her support person, you know? Arvik's wife, I'm coming to see you. She's gonna have people there. See, she's got like a whole posse the whole time. I kinda like bother her because she's like, Chardonnay? I know you said beer, but I will.
Is that
yeah.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what
I guess right?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Wente.
It's very hard to get the right wine. My wife is allergic to fish, so. I'm hanging with your social media people and everybody else.
Okay.
Bye. Oh my God, I love my wife. She's so cool. She's so cool. I want to film her. Can I go film her?
Okay, so this one's called Stupid Chicken because my family's from Germany and like I have all these terrible things about like trash.
I'm not here. Keep going.
He's my husband. He's live streaming.
You're on Twitch.
On Twitch.
In the art category. You want me to? I'll go away now.
Yeah, everybody says
they're see, they get scared because they know I'm streaming on Twitch. Since they know I'm streaming on Twitch, they get scared. They're like, oh my God. Oh my God. More drinks? I don't know about that. But she's obviously busy. You know what we're gonna do? Hey, let's do top to the bottom. Let's start on top. We're gonna start on top. We're gonna do a little bit of a whirlwind tour. And I know most of the artists here. I am a scary old man, I know, with a camera. Even worse. Look at that, broken up albums. This is post-traumatic garden, acrylic and broken records on floral. God, I love how it catches the light. It's like so cool. I'm glad I put the camera on my shoulder. It's much easier to stream. So who is that? Is that Lauren? Oh no, that's Bebonkwe Brown. That's one of the new artists that's here. And Lauren's not here. Lauren is a friend. Lauren, she's one of the artists in residence. She's doing local artists in residence. She does all this. And she's cut herself like a ton of times doing these things too. Yeah, she's the one doing this stuff here. And we can go maybe bother Nil. Nil's a good friend. I want to go talk to Nil again. This is Nil's stuff. It's Doris's neighbor. Nil. She's super awesome. Super duper awesome.
I think so, yes.
She's so cool. I covered her stuff before, but I want to do it again. I love Nil's stuff. We have to figure out what piece to buy from Nil. We have to figure out what piece we're going to buy. We have to save our money up and get it.
Buy all of them.
Buy like five pieces.
One of
everything. Oh, she's there's something different going on here, Nil. What's this about?
Yeah, these are some abstract.
From the last time.
Yeah, these are some abstract prints I've been working on.
Yeah? Like pushing the boundary on the abstract thing a little bit.
For sure. So I have been kind of experimenting with pretty much the limits of what I can do with mark making and saturation.
Oh, God, I love that.
In terms of monotypes.
Uh-huh.
So, like in that one, you can see like little bits of glitter and like how saturated like the pigment is in some areas. Oh. And like that really fine line work.
Oh, yeah.
Deep within, and I just love that.
Do you ever let the paint like dry on its own to create kind of a bubble effect or something? Do you know Katie? Katie, who had the opening up in Davidson?
Yes.
And there's a little bit of that in there. I mean, because she basically just lets the paint do its thing and she, like, kind of tries to pull the organic out of it. This looks like this was all intentional mostly. Right?
Yeah,
this was so there's like a lot of detail there.
Yeah, it was really early on in, like, my monotype journey. So I was being a little bit more strategic in how I was making the marks. And then as I kind of went
Are prints.
Yeah, these are
prints. Oh, I didn't notice that. Oh, my God, that's even harder.
Part.
Yeah,
that's
I get it.
That's the exciting part about it for me, though, is that it looks like paintings, but they're prints, and they have the same kind of weight and saturation as painting does.
Yeah.
It's
the whole print stuff just drives me crazy. It's just so cool.
It's just amazing what you can do with print. You can just really push the limits of, like, what you're doing.
I can't wait to see what Miles does with print when he gets pushed on that because he's Mr. Graphic lines and plotter guy. When he sees this,
oh my gosh,
I'm sure he's already been kind
of. I'm already thinking about like, can I just take all of your stuff home with me?
Okay, that's pretty great. Yeah,
stuff is amazing.
We were down there talking to him earlier.
Yeah,
so. Here's your this is the stuff I know you for.
Yeah,
your portraits, which are so great. I love them. I love them. I want one. I want all of them. Which one should we get?
Subscribe now
and
buy a painting.
I am. I gotta keep the tech job going so I can take from corporate America and,
Give to the
arts. Oh my God. It makes you feel less dirty a little, slightly.
Right.
They know what I'm talking about. Most of these people are in tech, so. They have no idea what art is. I mean, they do. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be mean. Yeah, no, not today. Anyway.
Someone's unsubscribed. They're like,
they just give me crap all the time. That's only. Wow. Yeah, I know. Oh, man.
So most of your subscribers, like, local, or are they just, like, all over?
They're all over. Germany, Romania, Australia, we get, England a lot. I actually started a coffee talk stream in the morning so we could get our Euro-Asian group again, because I got to be really good friends with them and I was staying up late. And then you start streaming at night and they're asleep. So,
you gotta strike a balance.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So it's been really fun to, oh wow. Yeah. Oh, look at you. I don't think I've seen that before. She's pushing the boundary. Neil's pushing the boundaries on everything.
The ceramics.
Did Darius like literally like grab your arm and like?
She was like, "Play now," and I was like, "Okay." She didn't have to twist my arm.
And I've been trying to kill her because she loves the clay. She's just so into clay, but she's got such a figure art possibility, you know. And Eva's always saying that. Eva's always like, you know, and I'm like, you know, honey, I love your sculpture, but you've got this. That tool over there, and you know, it's just yeah, no, I don't like that. It's like that's easy. I can do that anytime. And I'm like, ah.
That's the life of an artist.
I know. It's
like
it's,
we can knock out the easy stuff anytime. It's the hard stuff.
It's the stuff you want to push yourself on. And I imagine, yeah, I'm learning that. I mean, I'm learning a lot more about artists as I get thrown into it.
You're versed in JavaScript, but then somebody's like, let's do Python now, and you're like,
what the hell? Speaking our language. Neil, are you a techie at heart somewhere in there?
Low key, a full stack web developer.
What?
Low key. I don't actually do it.
Did you do a little bit of Django there once upon a time, maybe?
Maybe.
I've never done any Django, but we were Python for a while, JavaScript, that kind of thing. I actually, yeah.
I'm mostly sticking to JavaScript drama.
Python's like an old girlfriend. That I mean it that threw all my stuff in the street and I mean it was really good for a long time and now it just doesn't make it, doesn't cut it. So we code in Go and some of them like Rust, different languages. But people get so religious about like technology. Did they get like that in art? Like with techniques and stuff? Like if you use a technique that somebody, or if you make, like Doris has a thing about overly gaudy frames where the piece is like secondary to the frame, and then you know that's like
that's true.
I probably shouldn't have told you that, but that's like one of her things that will like trigger her immediately. It's like, you know,
right? I mean, it's true though. I mean, like, I don't know if it's so much as like a similar thing with coding as much as it is with art.
Yeah.
I feel like if somebody has a different technique to do something,
yeah,
they kind of almost admire it, and they're kind of curious to learn more about it, because maybe what they're doing might not be the most, like, the best approach.
Yeah, but they're not like, you bad, you're doing it the wrong way kind of thing. There's much less of that, right?
Right. Except if you're doing
Where's your card? I'm going to go zoom in. I want to show them your Instagram. Thank you very much. I'll move on.
Cool.
Thank you, Neil. Hey, there's some of Doris' stuff. That's
so
good.
I'm so sorry.
That's you're good. And there's the Holopaw stuff. This is the piece that was in the Mint. That's her piece that was in the Mint Museum. Disney World. Oh, I know. Disney World does great art. Paintings of horses. They do belong together. I know. I think they do belong together. I know. That I literally took that photo on our honeymoon. There's Neil. Go check Neil out. You want to go see her art. She has great art. The artist is Neil on Instagram, or the artist Neil.com. And I mean, come on, she got. Neil is amazing, man. All right, we'll continue our summary. And that's Doris, yeah. We need to make one for Neil, too. And Neil's a good friend of hers now, because they've been next to each other for so long. What's up with the underwear art? I'd have to let my wife describe that to you. We need to ask her about that. But I could kind of paraphrase. that underwear is like a really powerful thing for women. It's a form of empowerment. It's a form of you know, rebellion. And so she's put a lot of statements in underwear. And she's become, originally she kind of became known as the underwear lady because she puts camel toes in all her underwear and everything. And she makes the underwear that, I mean, she's done a lot of them at this point. And that's not her main thing, but she's done a lot. This is a print. She did a, that's a print. I mean, that came from a stencil, actually. Excuse me, sorry. So let me show you some more here. These are all, these are stencils that she did that she was inspired by from her, like, when she did her residency of, she did a residency. She did a residency with the graphic. Oh, shit. I gotta go.
Let me check. I can't remember.
You
wanna say it's...
They're asking me what's up with the underwear, so I want you to answer that question later. Excuse me. Thank you. She's making a sale. She's making a sale. I gotta run away, because I'm gonna screw up the sale. Because I'm a dork. Shoshana Weinberg. This is pronounced gouache. Gouache. I learned. So this is one of the new residents. So the art that's up right now is the new residents that just came. This is their first show. So the reason they do a show, a big fancy show like this, is because they just got a bunch of international residents. Some of them international, some of them from the States. So that's Bree. It looks like Bree's a photographer. Yeah, give me Matt. I know that's how I am too. Look, you just have to accept that it's not going to speak to you. It's not going to be your thing. I tell her that all the time. I'm like, it's not my thing, and she goes, I'm not making it for you. She's right, because the women that she talks to love it. They love it. It's like, it's something very visceral with women. They just really associate with it. And I don't. This is Taylor. And Will. We went to Will's show the other day, too. A long time ago. Some of you might remember when we went to Will's show. Some more from Taylor. It's just... Oh, no, I know.
I can do a lot with panties.
No. When I look at it, she goes, I just don't like looking at it. It disturbs me. She goes, good. Because that's her thing. This is Bill. Will. Is Will here? Will's done some amazing stuff. I can't believe this. I can't believe that's Will. He has a kind of a variation in his art. I'm pretty sure this is Taylor. Monica Talks. You know, I think she should too. She said before that she wanted to do a series for men. She did a series on toxic masculinity that was really good. But she used soft toys for that. She put like ripped up bunny rabbits, and she put toxic masculinity in there, all the things you'd hear in the locker room, you know. Gender stereotypes are her thing, not so much, you know, the shit that we're supposed to do or we're told we have to do, you know. So Taylor does a lot of paper mache. That's the main thing that she does, one of the main things. I love her stuff, man. I love Taylor's stuff. I love it. I want, like, several of her pieces. Her pieces are so crazy good, man. It's kind of skater arty. This is Bill for sure. Will. Yeah, I recognize him. I wonder if they're here. No, there's Will's not. Will's not here tonight. He loves trees. But he's got quite a range. He does lots of different things. He doesn't just do trees. But this is one of his major things that he does. front of the almond milk? I don't know, let's go see. Almond Breeze. Original 60. I think it's just a recreation. Isn't that crazy? Fruit rings. This is all flannel. It just makes me so happy. I swear I want that so bad. I want that so bad. I don't know why. It just reminds me of my childhood for some reason. It's all flannel. She's so talented. My wife just got the a curator, like, to notice her and mention to her, and then retweet her. It was really a big deal. My wife literally like woke up and was like jumping around the house. They retweeted Taylor, because Doris told them about her. Junk food. Wear a mask. Taylor Lee Nicholson, December 3rd to 17th. I think that's one of her other shows. God, I love her stuff. It's so cool. I love it so much. Look at this. Where is she? Why is she here right now? Taylor's another one of Doris' good friends. Because they're here together. Oh, I'm gonna stream until my phone dies. This show only goes until 9 o'clock though. I still want to do QCA at 9:30, so I'm gonna try to get home and by 9:30, so we can talk about tech stuff. God, that one's kind of morbid. Okay. Yeah, if you want to be here for QCA at 9:30. Let me know. I mean, Friday night QCA is probably going to be a lot more interesting. Yeah, on Discord. Yep. Look at this. She made a papier-mâché toilet with a phone in it. Because she dropped her phone in the toilet.
Be safe, Joe.
Be safe. Harris Teeter. Wow. Gosh, she's so talented, man. She's so amazing.
Looking forward to the morning coffees. I'll decay my lunches next week by an hour for it.
Oh, really? Yeah, Monday is going to be my first try. And we'll see how it goes. I'll try that on Monday. I just love Taylor's stuff. I do. There's Taylor. There's Taylor with her art. She's so funny. She's totally a skater, dude. She's a skater, dude. Skater girl. I've never met Taylor. It's funny because we know a lot about each other, but I've never actually met her. This is new. Who is here? There's nobody here? Is that Chris? That must be Christopher. This is new. I haven't met Chris. Oh, yes, I did. Yeah, I met Chris. Chris's stuff that he should be doing the art murals. Yeah. Yeah, I met Chris. Yeah, I think I have just learned some news about Chris, too, we can't talk about. God damn, that's realistic. Yeah, this has got to be Chris's space, too, I think. Yeah. 829. What else we got? Anything more on this level? Anything more? Oh, there's more Miles stuff. We talked to Miles earlier tonight. Like at 6, we talked to him. Miles stuff we talked to at 6. God, look at that. It's like multi-layers on that. How did he do that? Is that like 3D printed?
something plotted or 3D printed? That's crazy awesome. Can you see the layers of that?
Is this place always a museum or just for this event?
No, this is constantly, this is a renovated church. It was turned into a museum. And it was, it's called the McColl Center now. And they invite artists in residence, and then they have, at the top floor is artists, local artists. And they rent space at a subsidized rate. When we met Miles, we talked to him already. So they rent at a subsidized rate, and they have access to all kinds of materials here and networking and stuff like that. This stuff over here is some art that's been done. This entire church burned down, and then they renovated it. This art has been around for a long time. There's the bathrooms.
I guess it's layered prints with thickly flowing paint.
Yeah, I think that might be. I don't know. That's what I want to know. I want to go ask him how he got his layers on that. We were talking to him first. He was the one with the plotter. If you go back in the beginning of the VOD, we went and talked to Miles.
There's bathrooms.
Yeah, there are bathrooms, believe it or not, which I shall not go into because reasons. Let's go to level 2. Oh, you want to see something sneaky? Do you want to see something? Here, I'll show you. There's like a secret ghost place in this church. Yeah, you can go there. Yeah. Sorry. Hi. How are you? That was. This is almost like Cyberpunk. Yeah, Skyrim or Cyberpunk. Yeah. Like totally redone, right? So here's Miles' place. I do a tour of this about once every 4 months when they get new residents. So we'll probably do another one in January. So this is a different artist. This is Shoshana Weinberg. We haven't met her yet. So Shoshana, Miles, and the woman with the name I can't pronounce are the new residents. And they are here from September 8th to December 19th. And they travel from all over. And sometimes they come internationally, sometimes they're from America. And then there are local artists who are kind of here all the time. And my wife is one of those. And they have, you know, there's only like 4 or 5 spots for local artists. And they pay like a minimal amount to rent. There's a 3D printer over there. This is a print shop. And this is like the major print shop over here. Yeah, it's really fun. That's a fun place to tour. The person who runs the print shop is really fun. I forgot her name, though. Hi. So here's Miles again. I'll go show. I'll go look at this. You see the thing that plotted out earlier? You see that? That's the finished version. We started plotting tonight at 6 o'clock. And that's like the finished plot. We'll come back and ask him later. We were just trying to figure out how you got your layers on your art in the top level. You know I love it. On the third floor?
Is there a print on the third floor?
There's 2 prints on the third floor, and they are like quite a bit of depth in there. And I'm like wondering if you etched it or how you did it.
Surprise, surprise, it's an ottoman, right?
Cool.
Yeah.
I can't picture show what it is.
That's fine. We'll go figure it out later. He's busy. I'm here all the time. He's here all the time. He's with people. This is not the time for me to talk to him because I'm pretty much live here when I come visit with Doris all the time. So, and he's going to be here till December. So we'll go ask him all our questions later. When he's talking to potential buyers and museum curators and people like that, you don't want to mess with them. You don't want to be the geek with the camera. This is all Miles. Those are all copper plate etchings. Wait till you go downstairs. And one of the artists in residence is a dancer. Yeah, she's an artist, she's a film artist. You really have to be an extrovert to be a dancer. I mean, come on. You've got to be an extrovert to be a dancer. I wonder if there are introverts who are dancers who just do it because it makes them able to get out of themselves, you know? are things going? All right. I don't know what else is on this. I don't know. Is there anything else on this little? There's this. Oh, Miles did this too.
I'm gonna guess no.
Yeah, I think Miles did this too. Isn't that great? God, I love neon. Fucking love neon. I want, if I were to make art, I would, if I ever had a neon sign behind me in Twitch, like in my studio, I would make the thing. I would figure out how to make it. That would be so cool. I want to do that.
I'm an introvert. I like taking ballroom dancing. I like doing it to get access to specific types of extroverts.
Uh-huh. Yeah? That makes a lot of sense, actually. That makes a lot of sense. I think, like, Prince, for example. Prince was a total introvert. But, my God, you get him on stage and he'll, like, rated R or have to, you know, hide his penis kind of guy. You know? I am out on the front lawn. Oh, that's Shoshana. That's the dancer, I think. I don't know. What, looks like they're closing down, though. What time is it? I think we're gonna go outside. I don't know. We'll find out. It's been a fun night, though. I really had fun. There are some scary places. You want to see some scary places? There's places in this area that are like ancient. My wife will have to take us there. I don't have access. There's a band out there. I definitely know that guy. Scary places, you wanna see him? Oh my God, look at this. This is the main floor. We didn't even cover this yet. Wait, who does this? Oh, that's Shoshana.
We should top that off.
I sense our alcohol is getting a bit low. Look at that. Fragments of perception. Laser cut mirrored acrylic, fired glass, $15,000. It's super pretty. Just don't break it. Yeah, Shoshana's got multiple.
The level is starting to taper off. Gotta top it off with some scary stuff.
Here's Miles again. Same as before. How does he do that? Can you see the depth on that? How does he do that? I don't know, man. It's called sofa. Screen print with puff ink. Oh, okay, look. Puff ink additive on Somerset satin paper. Okay, it's got puff ink. It's ink that puffs up. Apparently there's ink that puffs up. I would never have known that. How would you even know that? I guess that's why you go to art school. Brie. Yeah, I think it must be like, yeah.
The couch looks like it was everyone's grandma's.
Mason jars. That's Brie Grant. We only have like a half an hour before they close. But this, they're gonna be up, this display is gonna be up for a while. That's Shoshana. Shoshana Weinbach. She likes gouache. Gouache. Doris got really into gouache when she was stuck in the apartment before McColl. She did. She got really into it. She was doing it all the time. Jars of weed. I don't think it's actual weed. It might be. You know what's interesting about this? She let so much of it drip. Do you know what I mean? It's like she deliberately let a lot of it drip. I know, you know what I mean? That's kind of unique. Babonque. Babonque Brown. Trade the memory of this night. Babonque. Babonque Brown. Fox fur and bicycle inner tube. Fox fur and bicycle inner tube. Very interesting. The internet has watered down art? Oh, hell yeah. I think it does. You kidding me? After seeing this stuff? I mean, the internet's got great art. Don't ever ask my wife what she thinks of the Twitch art category. She's nice about it, but, you know. She's definitely got opinions. I mean, it's not cheap to make art this way, to tell you the truth. There's more Babonque. I realized
recently that I like art, just not Instagram art.
Yeah. Well, that's actually what she calls it, too, Instagram art. Yeah. And you'll see people that'll, they'll stream their... That's an inner tube. That's a bike inner tube, my friends. People will, stream themselves in front of a canvas or something like that, or they'll take a picture. Everybody's got a different style, though, so it's just like coding. It's hard to judge them, you know? Okay, so this is where my wife spends almost all of her day, and we can't get in there. We have to have her show us. This is where she spends almost all of her day down there. Down in that back corner, that's where all of the kiln is. That's where she's doing all of her stuff. Oh my God, Taylor, that's huge. Taylor's making that huge piece right there. Look how big it is, that tree. Oh, that's amazing.
Not to be judgmental or anything.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, it's look, you know, and you know, there's room for everything. It's like room for everything.
I should have changed my shoes.
We're on the main floor. Never mind. We're on the main floor. I'm sorry about that. I didn't realize where we were. Okay, so here's the new artists we have. Material culture. The material objects that our various cultures create are imbued with incredible power. Domestic objects. That's Doris's art show. It's called Domestic Object. Family photos, furniture, spoons, mirrors become essential. Material culture features the work of McColl Center's Fall 2022 artists in residence, Babonque Brown, Miles Calvert, Bree Grant, Shoshana Weinberg. These artists use everyday objects and commercial technologies used to manufacture them. To trigger memories, examine concepts of beauty, build community, and expand how artists work. First Nations artist Babonque Brown celebrates her creative traditions in contemporary ways. Her painted color fields are combined with what she calls intertribal patterns drawn from historical and contemporary First Nations traditional art. Oh, that's right. Babonque is a Canadian First National, by origin. I forgot about that. Yeah. Inner tube spoons and other recycled objects in her mixed media work reference hybrid identities that are tied to rich past and the present. Brie Grant work documents culture histories and collective happiness intimacy in the hometown of Detroit. There's an auto show going on there right now. A former documentary photographer, their performances and installations use photos and personal objects to consider how our understanding of self affects our relationships to others. The question of self is central for Shoshana Weinberg. Her paintings and collages have distilled visual language of legs and red lips, stripes, and crooked teeth to create work that investigates the complexity of heritage and identity. Interested in the role that industrial technologies such as laser cutters and 3D printers can play, Shoshana integrates new materials. Printmaker Miles Calvert holds a similar interest in industrial technology and its impact on manufacturing art making. He prints often reference traditional or regional design domestic furniture, whose patterns and forms place them in a specific culture, place, and time. Miles' prints are experimental, using contemporary technologies including neon inks, screen printing, plotters, and laser cutter prints to create works of question class, location, and gender identity. Material culture is a part of the artist in residence program in McColl.
Miles Calvert is supported as a McColl Center Artist in Residence in partnership with the Wingate Foundation. So a lot of these artists, they're fully funded. They're, you know, they pay to have them stay here. And they, oh my God, there's Doris's piece. I feel your gaze. I didn't even realize that was hers. Franco Azim. That's the one that she released to be made. That's a print. There's like, there's multiple prints of that that you can get.
Yeah, that Doris.
It's like, hey, yeah, I forgot about her print was put in there. Yeah, they put prints in here so people who don't want to pay like $3,000 for a piece can like dial it, you know, still dial something up, you know. They can still get something. All right, let's go outside. God, look at that rig. Is that a Behringer? I think it is. Oh no, it's the Yamaha. It's the bigger Yamaha. That's the MG12XU. I have that exact board, but I have the dials on mine. I think I just have the MG, I think it might be the 10XU. I have that exact same board. I love sound engineering. Is it too late to get food? I'm hungry. Those officers are enjoying this. Oh my God, I wish you could smell this. I wish you could smell this right now. Oh my God, it's like so crazy good smelling. Look at that. Oh my God. Oh, it is a definite grill, yeah. Yeah, this is, you know what? This is like the third or fourth time they've had this, but it's doing way better tonight than it's ever done before because it's cooler outside and they have a band outside. It's like, they're really knocking it out of the park this month. It's because, I think it's gotta be because it's cooler. Hey, Tomato, how are you? We're gonna get a roadie or something. What should we buy? I mean, should we go see if we can get a menu? See if we can get a menu. Whatever that is. I know. I don't even care what it is. Whatever that is, I want it. It's been smoking over there since 6 o'clock. I want what she's having. You know what's funny is I've been trying to cut back on my meat, but come on, this isn't fair. I'm not anti-meat. I don't want anybody to freak out. Oh my God, I wish you could smell it. Oh my God, you see the smoke is billowing? Just like wafting my way? Oh, I wish you could smell it so bad. So good. You think they're sausages? I don't know what they are. You know what I love? I love it when the cops come out of their cars and they like have a fun time at the party. You see them there? That, they do that in Mooresville too. They like, they kind of let their hair down, you know, their crew cut down, and they just come chill out because they know it's going to be a good time, you know? I like that. Vegetables. No, you know what? I can eat smoothies in the morning if I can eat that tonight. It's kind of loud over there though. I know that guy from. I know where I know that guy from now. He used to perform at Hey, Cash. I am dying to get whatever is on that grill back there. Whatever it takes.
Okay.
Money is no object. Oh my God, this food truck is like over 9,000. Awesome. Not all the food trucks are created equal. I mean, some of them are good, but you know, people just have different tastes. Oh, that smells so good. My stomach is like really ripping me a new one. My stomach is like in circles. Taking those guys forever to buy anything. They probably already like did their quota for the night, so they don't like care. And because it's 9 o'clock, I think their band just finished. That was their last thing. Oh shit, they're coming to get food. They're coming to get food. I want to get my food first. I gotta cut them off at the pass. So meat is just concentrated vegetables.
She's there. No, you're not.
Can I do the charge thing here or no?
Yeah.
All right.
What flavor of wings did you want, baby? Charge candy or...
Oh, man. What's your favorite?
The jerk is spicy.
Yeah. Spicy. I want spicy. Jerk. Oh my God, it's so good. Do we have room for the mac and cheese too? Should I get the mac and cheese? You get two sides automatically? Yeah. Shit. I mean, something else. Rice and peas. What sides we get? We're gonna get mac and cheese and rice and peas.
Mac and cheese and rice and peas?
Oh, do you do roadies on occasion?
On occasion,
yeah.
It's very hard to come by.
It is.
My grandmother was the only person who made my
road. Yeah. I was on a religious mission. I'm not anymore, but I down there in the Caribbean on Trinidad for a long time. Yeah.
Yeah, oh my God, we go get Chefette, you know Chefette? It was like a kind of a fast food joint that just did, you know, roadies and like stuff. It's good. You're what? You're Jamaican, which is different, but yeah.
Yes, sir. Can I get some drinks off on the ride?
Yeah.
Good. I noticed all the islands had a different thing. So like Martinique, Trinidad, and Jamaica, and yeah, they all had different Creole kind of thing. It's good. Yeah. Hey, hi. Sounds great.
Oh, thank you, man.
Yeah. Hey, have you ever played Old Town Public House in Morgan and Cornelius or something like that?
No, we actually haven't played out in Cornelius in a while.
I feel like your drummer did at one point.
Probably.
Yeah, he did. Percussion guy?
Yeah, he's played at a lot of different places.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I think I know him from there, yeah.
Yeah, we're set.
Friday, my dude. Hey, Pamper Car. Karen, how you doing? Oh, this is someplace we're not going to scare people. This is someplace we're not going to freak the fuck out. I figured out where that guy was from. I got to go talk to him about that eventually, but not right now. Sorry about that. Every time I unplugged my phone, it like disrupted the power in the battery. And it made it like freak out. Oh, I am so hungry. I don't even care. Oh my God.
my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. I need a beer. It's so messy. Oh my God. I need like 10 of these. I am, I'm gonna need like 10 of them. She did, but like, these are like wings. These are wings. Yeah. Oh my God. That sauce is so perfect. It's like not too spicy. Oh my God. It's so good. I was hungry. I did not eat since like 6 o'clock. So I hope my wife has food. She can be hungry. I should bring her some food. No, she can't eat. She gets so worried. Wait, how does this open? Dude, it's like up for the mac and cheese again. Oh my God. So good. The mac and cheese is smoky. It's got smoky in it. It's like smoky mac and cheese. Oh. Yeah, you can DM me. I'm just eating right now. Unless you want to tell everybody. I mean, I'm okay with it if you are. Rob, dude, this is so... What is the name of that? We gotta find that. We gotta find that place again. I mean, you can't have a better night. It's like the perfect temperature right now. Good food. On the Mexican Independence Day. Yeah, it's not dark to me. No. I wonder if I should save some for my stepson. I might do that. I'm gonna save some for my stepson. He will love it. Oh my God, it's so good. It's so comfortable. I know. If we get more people, you could come over. I know. I was like, you know what? We got a personal invite to the Brazilian steakhouse from the owner. I told him, I said, I need to get a group. We need to go over there. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, you are fine. Thank you.
There you have it. She said, I'm fine. Oh my God, it's so singing good. I'm eating it too fast because it's so good.
Thank you. event was a big deal. This event is like legit really good. This is a really good event. Yeah. I've been to Tomagate. I know. Okay, Mom. Okay, Mom. Oh my God, it's so good. So good. I need to make room for my bones. I have to make room for the bones. The only thing I wish I had done this while the music was still going. Here, smell how good this was. I'm sure that'll go down well. Oh my God. This is the kind of meal where if you eat it with somebody that you're going on a date with, you can kind of tell whether they're going to be self-conscious around you or not, because you're going to make a mess. My wife? Doris? Is a fucking carnivore. When she eats, she's like, she got shit all over her face and everything. She looks like mild-mannered. You want your food no matter what? I could see that. Oh my God. That is so good. I don't know if I can eat it all. I hope I get to find it again. I bet their plain one would be good too. I feel like if you get the spices on them and the sauces, it kind of takes away from the smoke, you know? I mean, it definitely has it, but... my wife would eat it. I wonder if I took it to her if she would eat it. I need a napkin. Give me a sec.
was him. That was definitely him. So, chat, should I take the rest of the wings to my wife? Either way, I don't think I should eat all of them. I'll get sick. I think I'm gonna leave it, and I'm gonna take it to my stepson.
I got more of these.
Alright, need money. Wet wipes, I know, they should be. Alright. I can't eat all the rest of it. I just can't. It's impossible. It'll probably take me about 20 or 30 minutes to get all the way home. So, you guys don't want to, you know what, I'll just stream from the car, and then if we're late, we can go ahead and start. Yeah, let's do that, because I got to get home. All right. Well, I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Sometimes I wonder if I should just cancel QCA on Friday, but I think we could still do QCA on Friday, even though we're going out, you know? I think it would be sometimes fun for people to, you know?
I don't know how long it's going to take to drive home, though, is the thing. So we'll find out real fast. Let my wife do her thing. She can come home and tell me how it went.
Random guy talking.
Random guy yelling in the street. Make her run over. That guy's kind of like amped up. That guy over there's kind of amped up. I don't know if I want to walk past him right now. He's like totally yelling for no reason. That guy over there is totally yelling for no reason. I don't want to walk by him. He's like, he's fucking yelling at everybody. I just want to get to my car, man. Maybe he's a preacher. I don't know. You see him though? He's like yelling. Fuck, get me to my car. I don't want to have to deal with this dude. You guys a cop? Oh, they got cops in the parking lot. That's nice. Yeah, cops in the parking lot, that's nice. I appreciate that. I do. All right, give me a sec. I haven't done this in a while. Can you hear him? This guy's loud, man. We turned weird.
shit. God, my car always scares me. It always scares me like that. It's like I think the battery's dead and it's not actually not. Woo-wee! That was a fun night. It's gonna be relatively hard to get home, I'm afraid. But we'll figure it out. Sorry. That's spicy stuff, man. Yeah, I don't know. It's something to do with having your foot on the brake properly. Thank you, sir. You want me to go? What a nice person. It won't leave me shredded. Because it's a new battery. It's something to do with the alternator, but it's not... It's something to do with the power in the brake. Hey, we're part of the Mexican Independence Day celebration. Yep. Navigate home. Okay, go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. You go ahead. You go. You go. Okay. To turn left on Caldwell. I should honk my horn too. Should I honk my horn? Mexican Independence Day. I guess we're going through this one. Let me get on the highway and then I can talk. See me? Maybe. That's how you are? You're from Miami? Yeah, no.